Well, this morning, as most of you know, hopefully all of you know, we're celebrating 40 years of Holy Life Tabernacle Church. Amen. And around for all 40 years, Pastor Dave and Jeannie founded the church. Amen. And did ministry before then, and we'll read through some of the stats on that. But just appreciate their heart for the ministry. Amen. For the ministry of the word. We appreciate their heart for people and everything. You know, I'm sure everybody here has a story. Amen. I just want to ask real quick, who was there at the beginning of the birth of Holy Life Tabernacle Church? Just raise your hand. Who? Ryan? Angela? Hallelujah. All right, how about this? Who is here at the groundbreaking for this facility? Right here? Amen. Amen. Wow. It shows you the consistency and the steadiness of Pastor Dave and Jeannie for 40 years. And it really shows how long 40 years is. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, this morning, we just want to honor them. Today and at the end, we're going to have a chance to visit with them. And we have a card basket on the back as well. We'll start Facebook. If that hasn't been started, it looks like it has. Amen. And so I want to ask my wife, Angeline, to come up with me. And we're going to just read through some things. Hallelujah. And so I'm going to start. Pastor Dave and Jeannie have been married for over 45 years. 45 years. Amen. They've been in the full-time ministry for 42. So for 2 years before the start of Holy Life Tabernacle was incorporated, they were already ministering in many nations, and we'll go through those. They are the founders and have been the apostolic leaders of Holy Life Tabernacle for 40 years. And they've traveled to and ministered to 12 nations and 17 states. And so the 12 nations, Jeannie's ministered in Mexico, in Switzerland, and Ireland, and she brought Bibles to the underground church in the former Soviet Union, which is now Russia. And you can about imagine how full of faith you need to be to have to do that. And then Pastor Dave has ministered throughout the country of the Philippine Islands, Hong Kong, and Brazil. And together they have ministered in Canada, Guatemala, India, Ghana, and Liberia. And so let's give, that's a quite a testimony, you know, and missions and Pastor Dave and Jeannie are synonymous words, amen. Same thing with Holy Life Tabernacle is synonymous with Pastor Dave and Jeannie. A couple more stats here.
Okay, and there's more to that. So. Amen. So in February 1981, HLT was incorporated with the state of South Dakota. In March of 1981, that same year, they hosted their first public service in the basement of the fire and police building. In May of 1983, services were held at Starlight Inn, which is now known as Econo Lodge. December of 1989, the land was purchased on Mustang Pass for the building that we're in. In November of 1990, they completed and held their first service here. In January of 1996, they hosted their very first pastors' conference. In August of 1998, they finished a parking lot with concrete outside. In October 2003, they were recognized by Governor Mike Rounds for their spiritual contributions to the state of South Dakota. In November of 2004, they received a White House letter of recognition for their 25 years of service in ministry to our area from President George W. Bush. That was 15 years ago. This April of 2021, we will be hosting our 49th pastors' conference. Oh, okay. So I'll be the icebreaker of many testimonies to come this morning. I just wanted to thank you to Pastor Dave and Jeannie for all of this. And for everybody here, I just, when I look around, when I first come here, you know, there's just so much love here. There's so much of Jesus's presence that you can feel in this place that just makes it home to everybody that comes. And I just want to thank you all for being here, for showing us God's grace and love. And I just real quick want to share a little bit of my testimony with everybody. And so in 2013, 2014, you all know they have the Kids Night Out event here in the summer, and that's where my family and I came. And that fall, I came back. But just like a quick little back up there from that point, there was, you know, on the bulletin, it always says faith, hope, and love. And you can definitely feel that here. You know, God's presence is here. It's strong here. Worship is great here. And you do. You just feel at peace and you feel at home. And when I came, you know, when I read those letters on the bulletin, that's exactly what I see that. You guys show faith. You guys have so much love. You know, you just bring so much to the table. And you know, just having Jesus always just, it's always about Jesus. It's just so good in anything that you guys do. And, you know, we work with them here at the church. And, you know, they're flowing in the Spirit day in and day out. You know, there's not something that they don't think about it on their own. You know, they go to the Lord for guidance. They go to the Lord for support. And that's just, it's just so powerful and it's so good. I just wanted to let you guys know I love you. I'm happy that I can stand here and celebrate 40 years with you guys. And we'll go from there.
Amen. And, you know, the Kids Night Out's worked out well for me as well, because Angeline came to that, and then we were married shortly after, a year or so, I think. So, amen.
Amen.
The power of a bicycle. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, I just want to give a quick testimony as well. You know, I came to Brookings in 2006, in the fall of 2006, and I came to South Dakota State. And before I came, my mom had called different churches in the area, actually, and was just trying to find a good fit for me, a church that believed in the Holy Spirit, a church that was Spirit-filled. Amen. That's the background that I came from. And she called and talked to, I think she talked to Pastor Kevin, and, you know, he can get you excited about anything. Amen. And so when I first came to Brookings, this was the first church I visited, and I'm so glad that I did. You know, it was just, I haven't left in 15 years, and it doesn't seem like it's been that long, but 15 out of the 40 years I've been here. And like Angeline said, just the love from Pastor Dave and Jeannie, and it's a trickle-down effect, amen? And so they show love, and as a congregation, we show love to people as well. But I remember at my first service here, it was really good. I can't even remember what the message was about, but I'm sure it was very good. But I was walking out to my car, and I turn around, and somebody's basically sprinting after me. And it was Michael Foote. Some of you might know Michael. But he was sprinting after me, and he said, "Hey, you should come to our campus group." Woo! Amen. And back then, it was just the campus group. It wasn't called Firestarters. It wasn't anything like that. We met at Caldwell Hall, and we had, when I first went there, I think we had 4 people. And you can just see how much has grown in 15 years. And but Pastor Ginny had told him to intercept me and to invite me to Firestarters. And I'm sure she would have run out, but her heels would have been tough in her heels to get out to me. I was walking pretty fast. But it showed the heart. You know, there was no, there's a saying that I think her mentor had, but just one more soul. Amen. And for me, she wasn't going to let anybody get away. She doesn't. Pastor Dave and Jeannie don't let anybody get away without hearing the gospel, amen, without being invited, without being loved. And for me that morning, that was a real testimony to me that, wow, you know, they care about me enough to, well, instead of saying, well, we'll just see if he shows up at the next service, no, we're going to invite him for tomorrow. And it just shows the heart of Holy Life, the heart of Pastor Dave and Jeannie. And I remember just feeling right at home, my very first service. Just, I think everybody's talked about it, but you come in and there's nothing, for me, there was nothing that was awkward. There was nothing that was uncomfortable. It just felt very comfortable and it felt very right. And, you know, there was no anxiety because the Bible says that perfect love casts out fear. Amen. And in this church, you will find love here. Amen. And out of the 40, like I said, out of the 40 years of ministry, I've been blessed enough to be here for 15 of them. And now I've been on staff for 2 years, and I feel doubly blessed just because to learn under Pastor Dave and Jeannie is pretty amazing. All the knowledge, all of the experience that they have, how much they just fill themselves up with the word. For me, it's really been an eye-opening experience. And my dad was a pastor even before I came here, and I knew parts of the ministry, but Pastor Dave and Jeannie have opened my eyes to just a whole new side of it. And it's been very, just a tremendous blessing to be with you guys every single day for a while, and then as you move to Sioux Falls, be able to correspond with you and just be over the phone, and then every, you know, half of the week being able to see you guys and just picking his brain about different things, what's going on in the world, and we run things by each other and we bounce things off each other. And it's just such a great, he's been such a great mentor to me, Pastor Dave. And Pastor Jeannie, really appreciate your heart. And, you know, whenever I would stray when I was in college, you're always right there to give me a note of encouragement, a phone call, ask me how I'm doing and different things. So I appreciate that. Hallelujah. And I've learned a lot from Pastor Dave and Jeannie over the years. Some that I've taken to heart, some that I've been like, oh, okay, that's interesting. And I'm going to let you know some of this knowledge that I've learned right now. Okay. So from Pastor Jeannie, I've learned always to maintain peace. Amen. And I've learned to see it before I see it. Amen. So even this service, I was trying to see it before I saw it. I've learned many acronyms, like I always want to be fat. I want to be faithful, available, and teachable. And I also remember to win what's important now. Amen. And so Pastor Jeannie always keeps me even keel, level. From Pastor Dave, I learned that proper planning prevents poor performance. Amen. I'm not quite to his level on that yet. I've learned not to look like I've been baptized in pickle juice. And one of the most important things I've learned is that any appliance that I own should be able to last me at least 25 years. That's probably the most important lesson I've learned here at the church. So if I'm going on 20 years, my toaster, it's like, no, we can do this. You know, just put some tinfoil in there. It works. Hallelujah. Amen. But in all honesty, you know, Holy Life Tabernacle is synonymous with Pastors Dave and Jeannie Kaufman. And if you ask anybody that's been around this town, and, you know, if you ask them who are the pastors of Holy Life Tabernacle, they'll probably know that it's Pastors Dave and Jeannie Kaufman because of the impact that they've had in Brookings over the years, over 40 years. Amen. And throughout the years, people have come and gone, but they have remained steady. And they've been a light for this community. Just going through, just talking about all the times they went down to the bars to witness, pass out tracts. You know, heard many stories about, you know, somebody getting a tract during Hopewa Day or just, you know, a Tuesday, whenever people drink, and taking it home and reading it and just their lives being transformed, you know. And it's the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So we give all honor and glory to the Lord, but they have been willing vessels to be used by the Lord. Amen. And when I think of Pastor Dave and Jeannie, we don't have to put it up. I think of this scripture, though. Hebrews 6:11 says, "And we desire that each one of you show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope until the end, that you do not become sluggish, but imitate those who through faith and patience inherit the promises." Amen. And Pastor Dave and Jeannie have been faithful. They've been patient. Amen. They've let the Holy Spirit do a good work in their lives. Amen. I know that the Bible says that he who starts a good work is going to be faithful to complete it. And so this morning we celebrate Pastor Dave and Jeannie. I thank you guys so much for the impact you had on my life, on the life of my family. And we thank you for a lot of years to come as well. Amen. 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 At this time, I'm going to ask Ryan and Angela and their families if they wanted to come and maybe give some testimonies of their own.
I'll scoot over a little, but yeah, obviously Ryan and I were charter members of the church, 4 and 3 years old. And you know, being parents now, you think about just the risk that must have felt like at the time, both financially and a change of career and the commitment that it would have taken. To have kids now, we realize what a sacrifice and a step of faith that really was. I wrote down just a few things so I wouldn't lose track of my thoughts here. But for Joey and I, many of our major life events happened here at the church, where we met here, we got married here, we went to college at State, and each of our kids joined our family while we were part of the church here, and you guys all celebrated with us in that. And especially Davey, who was a surprise, I remember, just feeling like we could do it because we had the support of everyone here. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. So today, you may have noticed in the back, but, the 40th anniversaries are often commemorated with rubies. And they, may hold many different meanings, whether it's for a birthstone or for an anniversary, but passion, power, courage, and love are some of the main things. And I really think that those are perfect words to describe a celebration of 40 years not just a career, but a life of ministry. And we're all familiar with Proverbs, and it compares rubies to wisdom, and really that wisdom exceeds rubies, but to be compared to that is shows their high value, and of course shows that wisdom comes with time, and 40 years really exemplifies that time. So Hebrews 13:7 says, remember your leaders who taught you the word of God, think of all the good things that has come from their lives, and follow the example of their faith. And then also 2 Corinthians 5:7, and it says we live by believing and not by seeing, or we walk by faith and not by sight. And really, anything that takes this amount of time takes persistence and diligence and looking beyond the day or looking beyond the circumstances. And in many careers that people would consider noble, it often comes with days that are hard or thankless. And so thanks to you guys for exemplifying those things. Now there's all these coin phrases, emotional intelligence, and different things that would describe people that have been persistent and done maybe well with long careers or relationships. But really, it's thanks to your spiritual commitment and your grounding in the faith, and that you've taught us well. So, amen. Thank you.
I'm Joey. I'm Joey, Angela's husband. I told Angela it was probably, it was 25 years ago this month that this guy started peppering me on my answering machine wanting to invite me to church. And I was a college kid that was broke, busted, and disgusted, and I was on the wrong path. And my mom lived in Rock Valley at the time, and Pastor Dave's roots, and some people knew him back then, Pastor Doug's roots also, some people knew him back then, and they knew he was a pastor in town, and so they called him and just said, hey, can you give this guy a call? Well, I'm glad I'm glad they didn't know the rest of the story at the time, because they might not have called. So obviously now it's worked out quite well, but back then, if you would have known, hey, I'm going to call this college kid that's struggling, and he's going to be your son-in-law, might not have called. So I'm glad he did. It's broke. Gotcha. So I'm glad he called. So it was 25 years ago, kind of about this in April when he started calling. I got a verse. I know. That's why I have to shave my head so you don't see the gray hairs after all these years. So I got a verse when I think about holy life and just, you know, what it means. It means, you know, great teaching. My sister and I, and my brother too, you know, we grew up in the church, but we grew up with poor teaching and steering us wrong, blaming God when we shouldn't have been blaming God. And they helped us recognize who the adversary is, right? And no, I did not bring my readers, no. I got to make it big. So Ephesians 4, 11 through 16. And he gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds, and the teachers to equip the saints for the work of the ministry, for building up the body of Christ until we all attain the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, so that we may no longer be children tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness and deceitful schemes. Rather, speaking the truth in love, we are here to grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ. And when I think about holy life, I think about, you know, they provide opportunities. It's not just Pastor Dave up here, not just Pastor Jeannie up here talking. There are opportunities abound for people to minister here. They teach people how to minister, right? They teach people to, and they encourage you and they exhort you to, you know, get out of your seat, go lay hands on people. You know, we go to church in Sioux Falls, and that doesn't happen. And some of their pastoral staff are leaning into Pastor Dave and Jeannie, trying to learn, like, how do we help do that? How do we make that happen? And so over pizza at our house, there's lots of times where Pastor Charlie's picking Pastor Dave's brain about, hey, how do you do this? How do you, you know, et cetera, et cetera. And so it's important to recognize what we have here, what you guys have here. I know we don't show up near as much as probably is what we should nowadays, but there are opportunities. And then I think about Pastor Jeannie, and it's amazing. The youth in Sioux Falls and the youth at Roosevelt and the kids that come to our house these days, they know Pastor Jeannie is the first person to go to prayer, you know, about anything. Something comes up, David, let's pray. Okay, let's pray. And then we pray, right? And the other day, just a sort of a funny, but power went out during the national championship ball game at our house, and it was out for about 2 hours. And I made the comment, I said, ooh, if the power stays out long enough, we might not have school, right? And all these teenagers, Muslim students included, the first thing out of their mouth was, call Pastor Jeannie, call Nani, have her start praying that the power stays out. Because they know the power of prayer, and they know how that just... Mama's connection to the Lord. So anyway, thank you. We certainly love you guys, proud of you. You know, it's been an honor to be your son-in-law and to be able to call you guys mom and dad. And it's just been a great ride, and it's, we're going to continue forth. So amen.
Hey, everybody, Ryan Kaufman here. I think you all know me, so good to see you. My wife, Jennifer, she's in Des Moines today with Haley, my daughter, at a soccer tournament. So, but if you are friends with me on Facebook, you know we travel a lot. But yeah, so big 40, it's amazing. I don't really have a speech prepared or anything like that, but it's great to see you guys all here. It's just looking at the crowd right now, just a reminder of how much things change throughout the years as far as, you know, just new faces. There's some faces that are the same for several years, but just every year. But the one consistency, like Randon was saying, is just, you know, the love. No matter what crowd it is here, everybody just shows so much love, and that just comes from the leadership down. So trickle-down effect. So, I help. One of the biggest things I think in my memory is just kind of the building here. You know, just it was such a big deal just to kind of get this building here. If you weren't here for that part of it, so I help people. Yep, we prayed every night for it, and I help people get houses now. So, you know, people, I do mortgages, and one of the biggest things is first-time homebuyers. It's such a big stress for people to buy their first house. Well, if you're a pastor and you're not part of a denomination and you're not inheriting a church, it's a really big deal to get your first church. So it's huge, but really appreciate Randon and Angeline for helping out and stepping into leadership here in the last couple of years. It's amazing. So, but yeah, it's amazing. Thanks, everybody.
Yeah. Thank you, guys. God bless you. God bless you guys. Amen. Hallelujah. And you'll be seeing, we have some video, some pictures we'll show. You'll be seeing younger Ryan, Angela's, and Joey's coming up. So, and I think, I can't remember, Joey, if you were shaving your head back then or not. We'll have to see. We'll have to see. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, now we're going to have a couple people give a testimony here at the church. So first, we're going to have Kathy Fietner come up, so let's welcome her. Amen.
Thank you. Well, I love all the history of the church. That's amazing to me. And spirit-led and God-filled, we're so thankful. But what came up in my spirit was to focus on something that meant so much to me just recently, and is how the pastor, Dave and Jeannie, handled the pandemic. You know, the virus. I know we're probably tired of hearing about it. But the way they handled it was, first of all, it was from the Lord. It was spiritual. I felt such a peace. And, you know, he'd come on the social media. They used the social media after the church closed first, just a short time. He was courageous enough to open it up. But, you turn on that media, and there they were. Just calm, peaceful, filled with the Spirit. It was so precious to me and my family. Amen. So I wanted to focus on that, and thank you so much for that. You are true spiritual leaders, and you bring us peace. After we, church was closed, like I said, for a short time. Most churches just recently opened. But I think it was 8 weeks or 6 weeks, something like that. Yeah, 6 weeks, only 6 weeks. So we came back, and so good to be in church again. And they followed all the CDC regulations. Everything was available, hand sanitizer, gloves, 6 feet distancing. But he did not, you know, make us do it or anything. We could choose. We could choose our level of safety. And to me, that was just, that in itself is godlike. And we were able to sing. My aunt in a different town in the state just started singing maybe a month and a half ago. I thought, oh my, we sang. We sang our hearts out. But anyway, I made a short list. There are many, many things that Pastor Dave and Jeannie said that filled our spirit. But I just want to share just a few truths, reassuring truths that Pastor Dave said to us. We walk by faith and not by sight, and I heard that before. He said and reassured us, God is the author of peace, not confusion. And there was a lot of confusion, but God is our author of peace. And he said, Pray, pray, pray some more. Why worry when you can pray? And when we had the feeling of isolation, if we did, they reassured us God is always with us. He never leaves us or forsakes us. He's there. All God's promises, all of them, are yes and amen to me and to you. And then he said many times, and I believe Jeannie did too, prayed over us, 2 Timothy 1:7, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love and power and a sound mind. So I'm so thankful for that. And then the other thing that he preached before the pandemic, always preaches, is to be thankful in all situations. He reminded us that people in, like in India, or where there's a larger population, they had it much more difficult than we did. So he taught us to be thankful for the situation we're in. So that's what I want to thank you for, for your willing and obedient hearts to the gospel of Jesus Christ and to us as a person and our congregation. This verse came to me in Hebrews 10:23 for them and for all of us here at the church. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. And thank you so much. Thank you.
Amen. I'm going to have Deb Kulzbeck come up, and she's going to give a testimony as well.
Hey, what a day, huh? Great celebration, great celebration. So I was just going to share a little bit about when we first came to the church. We were going through a church split, and my husband and I, our hearts were breaking. And what we found here was a place of healing and restoration. And it still is a balm of Gilead. How many of you have found that? And then the second time we came back here, we were looking for a place. You know, at the time the Lord gave me the scripture from Genesis chapter 26, Isaac and his family and all of his animals were looking for a well. They were looking for a place of living water. And they found this first well, and the enemy had plugged it up and filled dirt in it, so he gave a name to it. I don't know what it was, dispute or quarrel or something like that. And he goes down the road and he tries another well, and that well didn't work, and they gave another name to that one. And then he goes down the road and he finds this place called Rehoboth. He named it Rehoboth because he says, and this was the word of the Lord to us, the Lord hath made room for us, and we shall be fruitful in the land. And Rehoboth, it means increase, it means enlargement, it means fruitfulness. And we found that here. We have room. Dave and Jeannie have made room in their hearts, in their lives, the whole church. You've welcomed us with open arms. And it has been a place of increase. It has been a place of fruitfulness. Thank you so much for making room for us, allowing us to minister, to use our gifts to the glory of God. And I pray that it would be for that for every one of you. This is a deep well here, friends. There is living water flowing here that will quench the thirst of your soul. And I thank you so much for always making a place for Jesus. He's always first. There's this wonderful worship here. There's always the encouragement to trust in God and believe his word. And thank you, thank you, thank you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Deb. And then our last person we're going to speak this morning is Roger Simmons. So welcome him as he comes up. Amen.
I can stay down here. I first met the Coffins probably in 79 or 80. They came and visited the church that I was at. It was because they hadn't started this one yet. And I think they were out scouting the town or whatever. And after they left, the pastor says, I'm going to go talk to that guy, and I want him to be our evangelistic leader, because he didn't want him to start a church. Because he was afraid of the competition, really. You know, because there is competition in churches, whether we like it or not, that, you know, everybody's after people. And he knew Dave, and he knew that it would be make it a little bit tougher for us. That's what he told me at a council meeting, you know, the pastor there, but it didn't work. So in November, the second Sunday that this place was open, I showed up because of things that happened somewhere else, you know, and I've been here ever since. So that's 31 and a half years. So I wasn't here at the beginning, but I've probably been here longer than anybody else, and he knew where I came from, and it didn't make any difference. So I've been blessed to be able to plug in and do a few things. Still doing a few things, or trying to, you know, but I know there's a spirit of excellence in them. And, you know, we've been talking a lot about Pastor Dave, but if it wasn't for the one on his right-hand side, they wouldn't have been as good or as far as they are now. You know, that's, you know, so it's a team effort. And I actually knew Dave before his part was quite so wide. You know, I probably shouldn't have said that. But. He had dark, curly hair. And so did Jeannie. You know, so I've seen him grow in the Lord. I've seen him mature. I've been in the background a lot and getting to watch how he handles the pastors' conferences, and we get to do things like that. You know, and there is no favorites played with those guys. There isn't no favorites here. You know, so it's a spirit of excellence that has continued from day one. I had a whole page of notes, but Randy told me I only had 2 minutes, so, you know, I left that at home. It's hard for me to get by with just 2 minutes, but it has been good. It continues to be good, and, you know, it's nice to see some faces from the past, and you're welcome many times. So just come and see us again, because you will be treated well, so.
Thank you, Roger. Amen. Yeah, like I said, you know, a lot of people have come and gone through the church. You know, and Pastor Dave and Jeannie realize that this is a sending ministry. Amen. So we have a lot of college students that come through, a lot of international college students that come through and go on to do great things for themselves, but great things for the Lord. Amen. And we always cherish those who stay in Brookings, all the college students that stay, and I'm glad that I did. Amen. You know, it really has been just an amazing testimony. You know, and you just heard three testimonies of Pastor Dave and Jeannie. And so now we did some people took some video testimonies for Pastor Dave and Jeannie. And you'll see some faces that you know, some faces that you might not, just of people that have been here through the years. Amen. So let's play that now.
We want to extend our warmest greetings to the man of God, Pastor Dave, and woman of God, Pastor Jeannie Kaufman. Happy 40th anniversary, and we would like to celebrate you, man and woman of God, for your service to the kingdom and for the personal impact that you have made in my life and that of my family. You've given me so many opportunities to learn and grow and do things in the ministry and do things in life in general. And I love the way you practice the word and the way you value people. And your ministry has such tremendous impact. And we just want to tell you that we love you and we celebrate you and we celebrate what you have done for God's kingdom and the impacts that you have made and you are making, you know, over this 40 years of impactful ministry. And we really thank God for you.
Pastor Dave and Jeannie, we are so excited to be celebrating 40 years of the Tabernacle with you. We are so grateful and thankful to have been able to be a part of your ministry and to experience the love and the grace and the compassion that you pour out on every single person who walks through your doors. We thank you for your teaching, for your leadership, and for all of the opportunities you've given us. Yeah. We have seen you raise so many powerful men and women of God, and I truly believe that every single person who comes through your doors is blessed and leaves better than they were when they came in.
That's right.
We are so excited to know you and to celebrate with you.
Yeah.
Thank you for your ministry and everything you've done for us. We love you.
Thank you. We love you, Papa. We love you, Mom.
Congratulations and happy anniversary, Holy Life Tabernacle. For 40 years, you've been a shining light to the community of Brookings, South Dakota State University, and many others all around this region. You have sent Pastor Dave and Jeannie and others from this fellowship overseas to nations abroad and have touched many more lives than you've ever known. Holy Life, you have been a beacon of the love, the light, and the life of Jesus Christ. Dave and Jeannie, you have been my pastors for a little over 4 years, but you've been a dear friend for more than 45 years. And during all of this time, I have seen two ministers of the gospel that have remained true to the call that Father has placed on your heart. Thank you for your faithfulness and obedience. It has touched my life and the life of my family. Your love for the Lord, your preaching of his word, your care for his body, it has blessed all of us. I know Father is saying thank you. Thank you for all you have done to further his kingdom. And I also know that Father is saying thank you to all of you who have so faithfully served in this fellowship over the years. As a former pastor's wife, I truly understand that without faithful leaders and servants with hearts after the Lord, a church very rarely remains fruitful and full of life. But here you are 40 years later with a hunger for more of him. So from my heart and from Paul's, I just want to say may the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit continue to pour out his blessings upon this congregation for many more years to come. And may the glory of the Lord fill this place until we see Jesus face to face. In Jesus' name. I love you guys. Mwah.
Happy anniversary, Holy Life Tabernacle. Happy anniversary to Pastor Dave and Jeannie. Such a great, great example that you've been to us. We met in 2009 in December. Just by a friend inviting us to Holy Life Tabernacle. The first service felt like home, which is what Jesse and I and our kids have always felt like. Every time we're in church, we're in your church, we're in Holy Life Tabernacle, we feel like we're at home. There's just a great spirit of life that we get any time that we're there. And to be able to serve in the ministry and to sit under Pastor Dave and Jeannie has just been life-giving, life-changing, life-transforming. Anytime we're coming back, it feels like we're going back home.
And you know, Pastor Dave, just like Sepha said, you have been a tremendous blessing to us. And you know, when I think of you, one of the major, major, major sermons I remember is the one you preached on standards. It has never, ever left our lives. And I think there were so many parts of that sermon that was so applicable in our lives. As far as finances, leadership, how we raise our kids, how we relate to other people. I just want to say you have been a major, major blessing. And Pastor Jeannie, you know it. The spiritual woman you are has so much been a role model to me as an individual. And I just want to say God bless you. You have no idea how much your influence in my life has helped influence other people in my life as well. I love you.
We love you so much. And just like Jesse said, I think it's rare that you get to find a church that you're imparted with just life, about ministry, about how to raise kids, about how to save money, you know, about how just to do life and ministry. So thank you so much on your anniversary. Don't hold anything back. You deserve everything that God has given you. Again, we love you all. Happy anniversary to the church and to you all. God bless. Bye-bye.
Whoop, 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 whoop.
Good morning, Pastor Dave and Pastor Jeannie. It's an awesome time. We're celebrating your 40th anniversary. Holy Life Tabernacle. I can't begin to explain how much you have meant to me. I met you, first of all, at Belden Capel's years ago. And eventually, I came to Holy Life when I was looking for a church. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me that day. This is where I want you. And I am so glad that I listened, because you have both blessed me awesomely. I remember that I came the Sunday before Angela and Joey's wedding, and you graciously invited me to come to the wedding. I thought, I don't know these people, really. You have blessed me tremendously. You've been an awesome teacher. And Pastor Jeannie, your women's Bible study is from the heart. It's so sincere that I just reflect always on how much you both love the Lord. And you are a fine example to each and every one of us of how to live a godly life, how to be godly spouses, and to raise a godly family. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart for being truly dedicated to the Lord, not being discouraged to the point of giving up. And I thank you for the opportunity to say just how much you mean to me. God bless you and be with you from this day forward. Amen.
Hi, Joel and Rita Hoglum here, coming to you from Arizona. Congratulations, Pastors Dave and Jeannie, on the 40th anniversary of your ministry. We were so blessed by your ministry for over 25 years.
And we praise our Lord Jesus Christ for counting you faithful and putting you into the ministry. And faithful you too have been to him and to his saints.
And we want to also say thank you for all of your teaching and preaching and fellowship and friendship throughout the years.
And thank you too for your love and for your encouragement.
Your many, many prayers for each of our family members was so important. We will never forget that.
Yes.
And we will never forget, this is my Bible. I can do what it says I can do. I can have what it says I can have.
We love you. May God continue to richly bless you.
Bye.
That's okay.
Hello from Bemidji, Minnesota, Tim and Kathy Pop. We love you, Dave and Jeannie. We thank you so much for who you are and for your life. And the number of years we got a chance to hang out with you. Kathy's got a couple words before I wrap it up here in a second.
Yeah, I just want to say I love you guys too, and happy anniversary. And I was just... when we were there in 1996, we moved there and we were part of the ministry. I just wanted to tell you that it was probably one of my most memorable times being there with you guys and with the fellowship of people. I just thank you for what you cultivated there in that ministry and just how you made us feel comfortable in being ourselves. And also... just wanted to do a little punch here for your book, Jeannie. It's just such a blessing to me. Thank you so much for writing this book and being transparent about your life. I've shared this book with several people and given several books away. So keep on going. Keep on doing this. This is great. Thank you. Love you.
And thank you, Pastor Dave, for your white knuckle faith. You're amazing. Your gift to pastors, everything that you guys do, the apostolic ministry that you have there. God go with you in the next 20 years, and we will see you soon.
Yes.
Love you, love you, love you.
Good morning, Pastor Dave, Pastor Jeannie. We have been thoroughly blessed to have known both of you and been part of Holy Life family. Debbie has been so encouraged to follow her calling to minister because of you. We enjoy, both of us, the worship that takes place at Holy Life. We love to bask in the glory of God as we worship. We knew Pastor Dave and Pastor Jeannie before there was a Holy Life. One time they invited us to special evangelical meetings in Minnesota. Debbie still remembers that the evangelist spoke on blind Bartimaeus that night. You made us feel so special as you took us with you that time. There was a time in our lives when our children were younger that we experienced 4 years of financial setback. During that time, for a few months, Pastor Dave gave me $50 a month for groceries. I believe that was his way of illustrating that he was standing with us, waiting for God to restore us. And today, I can say that we are abundantly blessed. Thank you, Pastor Dave. Another time, Deb was going through several years of physical issues, and we had gone on a business trip to Dallas and ended up flying back the very next day. As we got off the plane in Sioux Falls that day, there was Pastor Jeannie waiting for us. Now, this was before cell phones, and while you guys still probably lived in Volga. But nevertheless, there was Pastor Jeannie waiting for us. She whisked us off to see a doctor that she knew. And as we were waiting to see that doctor, Debbie remembers Pastor Jeannie saying, "God will pay back everything that you've lost." And today we can say that we have been blessed. And a large part of that is because of Pastor Dave and Pastor Jeannie. You've always been there to encourage us, always there to believe in us, and we're thankful for you. God bless you.
Happy 40th anniversary to Holy Life Tabernacle.
We extend our greetings all the way from New Bedford, Massachusetts.
Yes.
Isn't that awesome that
it
today
is.
Holy Life is turning 40 years, and we thank God for such an awesome church.
Yes.
And guess which people give birth to Holy Life Tabernacle, honey?
Is it not Pastor Dave and Mama Jeannie?
That is true. Such great people who have given us a church.
Yes.
That has raised a lot of great men of God.
Yes.
And great women of God.
That's
so
true.
What we want to tell Mama Jeannie and Pastor Dave,
yes,
is thank you.
Thank
May
you.
God continue to protect you for us.
Amen.
And we thank you for getting that vision,
yes,
to bring forth a church that is awesome, with one, the blessing of God, and
yes,
two, with God by your side.
Yes.
We thank you and we appreciate the love. Amen.
Yes. Amen. Happy anniversary to the entire Tabernacle family.
Yes.
To Pastor Dave and Mama Jeannie.
Yes.
You guys are awesome. We thank God for your life, for the blessings that you have instituted into generations.
Yes.
It is so amazing.
Amazing.
The kind of work you guys are doing. This is something that is so amazing. So we want to use this opportunity to say happy anniversary to you. And also, one testimony that we want to share is how you accepted us into your family. You used to call us that we are part of your family.
Yes,
this is
true.
Something that goes down and deep in our mind.
Yes.
And we can't forget it, for the love that you have shown us. So we want to say happy anniversary to you, and may God bless you.
Yes,
and
God
lead
bless
you to do greater things.
Greater things.
And you know that the sky is just the beginning.
Yes.
So happy anniversary to you. We love you so much.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
congratulations, guys, on 40 years. That's awesome. I don't know where to start. I've been in this church since the early 90s, and I remember just a faint memory of sneaking into the basement of the police station once or twice with my parents. So I've known you guys for a long time. Although we've all changed, we've lost hair, grown older, except Jeannie. She's
growing younger.
Yeah, I think she's got a fountain somewhere we need to find. But one thing that is, and I'm sure everybody else is mentioning, is consistency. You guys have always been there. You've always been grounded when we see you. You've been like an anchor for a lot of people. I mean, I've been through some dark times in my life, and you guys were there. And a lot of the people in the church don't even know my whole story. But you guys do. And you were always there, always encouraging me, lifting me up, had a word of encouragement, and every sermon right on. I mean, you guys are great. Always a word in season. And just encouragement. And you guys are just consistent all the time. You walk through the door, there you are. Consistency. You guys have been here for 40 years. And we are very proud to say that we're members of Holy Life and that you're our leader. And we're looking forward to however many years the Lord allows us to have with you guys. The fun works.
My turn. Yeah. Okay. Also, to echo what he said, congratulations and happy anniversary. We're very, very thankful and very grateful for all that you do for us and have done for us in the past. I started coming here in 2003. It was at the invitation of Anne, at that time Cyrie, now Roe, and I met my husband here, and you married us, and you have successfully given all of our children a strong foundation in the Lord. We're very grateful for that. You've become a part of our family. You've been in our home. You know our stories, like Jim said, and you love us anyway. And you've taught us to love others anyway. And that is a tremendous lesson. I never felt connected to a pastor the way that I felt connected to you my entire life. And it took me 33 years to get here, but I'm very glad to have found this church and found this church family. And of course, we've began a very strong relationship with Brandon and Angeline, and we're very grateful for that. Our children are growing up together. It's been a huge blessing. We have expanded our knowledge of other countries and other places because of you, and we look forward to many, many years in the future, and then a lot of years in heaven celebrating. So we thank you again, and happy anniversary.
This is M. Pastor Dikrus from India. Once again, I'm very happy to speak about my spiritual father, as well as mentor, Pastor Dave Kaufman, and Mom Jeannie Kaufman. They are a very lovable couple, and they visiting India every year with a lot of love and a lot of sacrifice. And you know, Pastor Dave Kaufman has a lot of fans in India. So whenever they see the pamphlet that Pastor Dave coming, people are very much lovable to come and see the Pastor Dave and listen to his teaching. And whenever we arrange it, people are crowded. There is no enough place. I can say through this pastor seminar, more than 1,000 pastors are equipped by his teaching, and the ministry was grown like anything. And many pastors individually meet me, and they say that after coming pastors to my church was blessed, and many people was healed. So their church also grown like anything. I know one pastor in Andhra Pradesh, he has only one church. After we visited and we prayed the church, and the pastor multiplied his churches. Now he planted about 11 churches in different places. Through Pastor Dave and Jeannie prayer, so many people got healed, especially cancer people healed. The couple who doesn't have many yet child, after Pastor Dave prayer, they got children. A demon possessed people got delivered through by their prayers. And also so many miracles has took place, like jobless people got a good job, I want to say my testimony also. The first day Pastor Dave visited my church congregation is so low, about 10, 15 people are there. But after he came here and encouraged my church and prayed those who are sick, and the miracle was started and fire was falling in my church. The revival has taken place. So he partake his anointing to me. So I started to pray the people. Now my church was grown like anything. Now we regularly 70 people are coming. Here I would like to say thanks to Tabernacle Church in South Dakota because of you sending you pastors with the sacrifice and a lot of effort. Through your contribution, they can come here and spread the gospel, heal the people, bringing many souls for the Lord Jesus Christ. So I would like to say thank to the Tabernacle Church, that one who's sending your pastor to India. We are so blessed. Thank you.
Good morning, Pastor Dave and Jeannie. We are so excited to help you celebrate this wonderful time of 40 years in your faithful and fruitful ministry at Holy Life Tabernacle. You know, I remember the day that you visited us in Texas when we were in Bible college 40 years ago, and you said you had some exciting news. And I could just tell in your heart the excitement that you had, for you put your hand in the air and you wrote Holy Life Tabernacle. You know, you were able to see it before it even began to be birthed. Yes. Yeah. And we are excited that after 40 years, you are still fruitful and you are still faithful to the call that God put on your life.
So powerful. You know, it's so neat. You know, look at the School of Ministry around the world now with just untold kids, you know, that are ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And, you know, I always said that the Tabernacle Church has the best worship in the country. And we still feel that way. There's just such an entering into the Holy Ghost and the things of God. So just wanted to say a great big congratulations. You know, it was a privilege and an honor for Cindy and I to be at the Tabernacle with you for many, many years. And now that legacy is passing on to Pastor Randon and his gorgeous bride. And so we just want to take a moment and say this morning, thanks again for your help. Thanks for your fruit that's around the world and a lasting legacy and an imprint that is going on and on.
Yes, that's so true. You know, I have a scripture that the Lord gave to me way back 40 years ago. And when I read it, it was just a powerful rhema word because it was a description of you, Pastor Dave and Jeannie.
Yep.
And this is it in James chapter 3, verse 17.
Yeah.
But the wisdom that is from above is first pure, then peaceable. It's gentle and easy to be entreated. You know, entreated means approachable, kind, and self-sacrificing. Full of mercy and good fruits, and without partiality and without hypocrisy. When I think of you, Pastors Dave and Jeannie, I think of that verse.
Yep.
And you know, I took again the privilege of writing out your name and saying K is for kindness. A is you are approachable.
Good girl, honey. Yeah, that's great.
You are unwavering.
Yep.
F, you are fruitful.
True.
M, you are merciful.
Yep.
A, anointed. N, nurturing. And S, self-sacrificing.
Powerful.
Thank you
for
40 years, 40 years to share the good news of Jesus Christ around the world.
Totally. Powerful prophetic voice around the world. Mm-hmm. So congratulations, 40 years. We'll see you in at the Pastors Conference. Can't wait.
Amen. That is so true, and you're such a blessing to all of us. And I think, you know, we had a lot of testimonies, but it doesn't even sum up how much you mean to us and this church, how much this church means to us. And again, you don't have Holy Life Tabernacle without Pastor Dave and Jeannie Kaufman. And so we want to present to you guys a gift. So if you want to stand up in front here just real quick, Pastor Dave and Jeannie. if we can show the congregation as well. Maybe take it out. And it's a plaque for 40 years with the ruby that represents 40-year anniversary. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Such a blessing. And then this morning, too, even with the Pastor Dave and Jeannie maybe protesting, I do want to take up a special offering for Pastor Dave and Jeannie. They have been such a blessing. And, you know, the Bible talks about honoring those who are in authority, honoring our pastors. And so you might have a card that you want to give today or maybe, you know, in the next couple weeks. And we have a card basket as well. We're going to have baskets coming to the front. And then at the back, if you just have a card, we have, it says just PDK and PJK, if you want to give it to Pastor Dave and Jeannie, just for, you know, for whatever. And it's whatever the Lord lays on your heart to do. But I do think it's important to honor them in this way. And so I'm just going to pray real quick, and then we got another video. But Father, we just thank you. We thank you that you are a good God, that you give us good things. Father, we thank you that we can give this as an offering not only to you, Jesus, but to Pastor Dave and Jeannie. Lord, that they're fruitful, that you bless them. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And while they're doing that, we're going to play a video collage for our offering song.
One by one they came, far as the eye. each life somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you had done, sacrifices made, unnoticed on the earth, in heaven now proclaimed. And I know up in heaven you're not supposed to cry, but I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so
love you guys. And now, actually, I'm going to take a couple chairs here. Pastor David and Jeannie, I want you to sit in front here, and everybody else can just put a hand out towards them. But we're going to have, let's see what I have. Amen. We're going to have Albert come first. We're going to just pray over Pastor David and Jeannie. Have a couple people here that are going to pray over them. But just stretch your hand out towards them as we pray. Amen.
Well, indeed, the Bible says that he who picks the work of a bishop takes a noble work. Father, we thank you for the life of Pastor Dave and Mama Jeannie. God, we thank you for such a vessel, Lord, you've made. God, we thank you for the grace that rests upon them. Father, even in these times when people are preaching perverted messages, where people are trying to be lukewarm so as to fit into the society, Father, Lord, your son and your daughter have made up their mind to be consistent. They are instant in season and out of season, unwavering. Father, I thank you for their lives. Father, I pray and I declare upon their lives, O God, that may they continually grow and prosper in you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I pray that may they continue to possess the mountains as Caleb, O God. Even in their old age, O God, may they look new and may they look fresh, O God. I pray, O God, that may they continually flourish in you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, may no weapon formed against them prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. Wherever they will go, oh God, I declare that place blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. May people see them and may they call them blessed. May people see them and may they call them Christ, because God, they depict and they radiate your glory. Father, I pray, oh God, that may they not struggle to minister in grace. Lebronda Zelevaroski Parandes Colabrosa Lebronda Zalavaroski Prades like streams of living waters, oh God. People may continue to come and draw from them, oh God, because of the grace upon their lives. Father, may their relevance be felt from now and even the generations yet unborn. Father, may their names not be forgotten in the mighty name of Jesus. In the archives and in the annals of great men, may their names be recorded in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in all things, oh God, may they be steadfast in you. May that peace, may that faith that they carry, may that love that they always walk in, may that principles that they walk in, may they continually, oh God, be consistent, and may they not turn to the left nor to the right. Father, I pray that all the days of their lives, goodness and mercy will follow them. In the mighty name of Jesus, we've prayed with thanksgiving. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to have Deb pray over him here as well.
Father, we thank you. You are the great shepherd of the sheep. Thank you for anointing these two shepherds of yours. And I ask that you would restore their souls. Go down deep, Jesus. Heal what needs to be healed. Make whole what needs to be made whole. Lord, I thank you that you wish above all things that they prosper and be in health, even as their soul prospers. Thank you, Lord, that every one of us who partner with them get to experience part of that blessing, that anointing, that favor that's upon them. And Lord, I release right now to them and to this entire body, Lord, the new thing that you want to do. The new thing, Lord. I thank you that you are going to lift the lid off the box, Lord, of our expectation, of their expectation, that you've got so much more ahead yet for them and for this church. And Lord, I thank you that they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And I declare, Lord, that they shall mount up with wings like eagles and soar above the trouble, above the challenges, above every difficulty that might come into their path. Lord, thank you that they're soaring and that your favor is upon them and your presence is going before them and giving them rest. And I thank you that they're blessed and that we are blessed. And thank you, Lord. May your name be glorified in every single thing they say and do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so, Father, too, I just thank you for their ministry. I thank you that, as Deb was saying, that they run and they're not weary. Father, even right now, you're filling them up with your Holy Spirit. You're filling them up. You continue to fill them up, Jesus, that they do not run on empty, Lord, but they run full. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Father, I thank you that if there's any weariness, if there's anything right now, Father, that they can go to you and that you give them strength, that you give them hope, that you give them peace, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you that they can find rest in you, that they can find their peace in you, Jesus, that you've given them a spirit of power, love, and a sound mind. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you that even as these last 40 years have come and gone, Lord, that the best is yet to come. That their best years are ahead of them in Jesus' name. That they're going to be able to reach more people than they've reached in 40 years. Lord, we thank you that you quicken their feet, that you quicken their step, Lord, in these next however many years, Father, but that they do more from this point on than they've even done in their first 40 years in this ministry, and even before that, Jesus. Hallelujah. That you give them supernatural strength. That you give them a supernatural touch and anointing to carry on what you've done, Jesus, in their lives and in our lives. We just thank you for them. We pray for good things, that you are a good God who gives good things to your children. You give good things to Pastor Dave and Jeannie. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just want to give you a hug here. Love you guys. Amen. Amen. And let me just check here, but that's the end of our service today. But actually, I want to have Pastor David Jeannie stay here. And if there's anything on your heart that you want to say, You guys have the floor, and you guys, there's no time limit on you guys. You know, I had to give a time limit on Roger, but no time limit on you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh,
thank you. Oh, I just want to look around the room at this beautiful group. I want to say hi to so many of you face to face, individually. Thank you for coming. Thank you for celebrating with us. And it's, we celebrate the Word of God today. You know, where would we all be without the Word of God? The Word is with us. He dwells among us. And, you know, His Word is alive. His Word has quickened us. His Word has healed all of us in our bodies. His Word has brought peace to our minds. His Word has gone forth over the ocean to show people Jesus' love. So everything goes back to His Word. So I'm so grateful today for Jesus. I'm so grateful for this beautiful service, pastors, that you put together. Thank you. It's over the top. Kids, I don't know what to say. Thank you. Our children, you know, it's not always easy being in a preacher's home, but we're in a happy season. We're in a good season, and we're grateful for that. And thank you for the words saying we're getting stronger and stronger, that we're entering into a season of even greater fruitfulness. Thank you, Minister of Helps. And, you know, on our hearts, on Pastor Dave's and my heart, is that till the whole world knows. Amen. And that's in our hearts. The Word burns in our bones. And worship is our middle name. And it's all because He did it. And if He's done it for anybody, He'll do it for everybody. It's not like we're wearing a crown. He's wearing a crown, and you are His royalty. We are all called with a high call of God in Christ Jesus. And my husband has been a rock for me, so I'd just be washed out without him. It's true. And so with the ability to stand on Jesus, so He reins me back in when I'm wandering. And grateful for you, my pastor, my spiritual leader. One more thing, you know, is just grateful for family. If your family's here, just take time for your family. Love them. You know, God's got an order. God is first. And family, and then ministry. Amen. So take time for each other. And thank you for your love. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for obeying Jesus. I know I'm getting the pat on the back to, like, wrap it up, girl. So I'm going to turn it over to my husband, my pastor, Dave Kaufman. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. We are a team. We stepped out in faith together. True. No church, no money, no people. Some thought we were crazy.
Yes.
But
no, you're crazy.
But all for Jesus. We hung in there. And turn to your neighbor and say, hang in there. Say, hang in there. You know, there's lots of things in life, and there's lots of things that storms come, but you just got to hang in there. Don't quit. Don't quit. Just keep hanging in there, and just don't let go. Amen. So thank you, Pastor Rand and Angela, and just for planning all this, doing this. Thank you, and thank you. Most of you are kind of new timers. So, how many are under 40 in this room? Raise your hands. How many are under 40? Be honest. You know. Well, a lot of people are under 40. Well, before you were born, we had stepped out in faith. And, you know, a Bible generation is 40 years. So for a generation, we've been endeavoring by God's grace to declare good news. And it is good news, isn't it? Amen. It is good news. And so we just bless you today. Thank you for your love. Thank you for celebrating us, celebrating with us. There's some old pictures up here. Yes, I did used to have hair. But you know, God is good. Amen? Amen. You know, people change on the outside. That's okay. Just on the inside, though. Keep your heart burning hot for Jesus. Amen. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, stay hot for Jesus. Stay hot for Jesus. And then we're all, you know, a lot of pictures even here. A lot of people are already in heaven. But, you know, we have one life to live. Let's live it for the Lord. Let's impact people around us. You know, your family first, impact them for Jesus and then others. Amen. So, Lord, thank you for your presence here.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for loving us, Jesus. I pray you wrap your arms around every person here today, even every person watching via Facebook around the world. Jesus, I pray you wrap your arms around them, draw them close to you. Thank you for your blessing on each person's life, that you are a God of love, that you bless and you don't reverse it. Your love is unconditional, that we experience your unmerited favor. Thank you, Lord, you're full of grace. And that grace spills out on us. So, Lord, for each person here today, I just speak grace over their lives. Grace over their homes or their marriage or their children in Jesus' name. Grace over their schooling in Jesus' name. Thank you for loving us, Jesus. Thank you for blessing people here. Thank you for blessing our time of fellowship, Lord. Even some treats, Lord. Thank you for blessing those treats. And, Lord, we just celebrate you today. Wow, 40 years compared to eternity is just a drop. But Lord, we thank you for your love. And thank you now for just this time as we fellowship in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. So I want to thank, too, the Fresh Fire and Back for their kind of serving up some things and stuff. And so if you want a hug, we're more than willing to give a hug. All right. We're just going to stay up here for a little bit. Yeah, thanks for the decorations and putting the things up and all that. So if you want to look at some old pictures, you can come up here too. But we just bless you now in Jesus' name. Amen. So you can take stuff with you as you go if you want, or you can sit down. Amen. We bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Amen.